Hello, everybody. Welcome to this episode of Web3 Tour on your SafePal extension wallet. Make sure you download the SafePal extension wallet. You can go on the main website, select browser, and then decide which one you'd like to do it. So I already have mine installed right here, and it's already logged in. So if you're new to SafePal, you can make a SafePal wallet and scan the QR code or import your wallet to access the SafePal extension, and it'll be done within under a minute. Moving forward, right here is the SafePal sitemap. This site will redirect you to different parts of SafePal. You want to go to the download center or the official website or the main Twitter account. You can use the SafePal sitemap to redirect where you need to go. Now, to begin our Web3 tour today, have your wallet logged in, and let's go to the first website. This is called DAppRadar. This is used to discover, track, and trade everything related to DeFi, NFT, and gaming. This website is great to explore different things. This is a third-party website, and you have to do your own research. Just because it is listed on this website, it doesn't mean that it's 100% safe. There is an option to connect your SafePal extension wallet to the website. Personally, I don't recommend it, but I'm going to discuss why people asked for this information. This is a request from a user, so I'm just going to go through it for them. You can connect your wallet, and this is going to show your portfolio of different NFTs and DeFi you have connected. The reason why I don't recommend doing this as a third-party app, in case it's compromised at any point, then your information may be leaked as a result to this. So it's not the safest option to do this, but some people like to do it. Personally, I have multiple wallets to do various things. Like, for example, this one is a testing wallet. So if I lose my money on it, I don't really care. As you can see, you have an option for MetaMask or Wallet Connect. If you're having issues connecting with the SafePal extension wallet using the Wallet Connect, you can click on the MetaMask logo and it's going to ask you to sign in and connect. And you can press it. And you're going to need your SafePal software wallet to confirm your transactions. So do note that when you're completing all these transactions through the app, you need your cell phone as long as the SafePal extension to approve it. If you just created the wallet within the SafePal extension and not using the SafePal app, this extra step is not necessary. I'm not going to do it today, as again, I don't prefer to connect my wallets, but you can. So these are the different stuff. And you can use it as your portfolio, but I don't need to. I'm going to log out. So we can click on Explore DApps, and they have different options of different chains that we have. And you could just go down and see what you want. And they categorize it as DeFi, games, social, etc. You have different filters. I think going based on volume is probably the best. So the volume is 150,000. So as you can see, OpenSea, that's another app we're going to talk about later. It's 5 million. Oh, Uniswap, 3.99 billion. You definitely want to deal with different DApps with higher amounts of volume. It's more likely to be safe. And yeah. Oh, I just want Ethereum. Okay, here we go. And these are the different DApps you can click on for Ethereum. These tools are extremely useful. You know, if you're new to the space and you don't know what you want and you just want to explore and understand different things, this is what this type of website is used for. If you say, hey, oh, I see this transit swap. Oh, this looks pretty cool. And then I'm going to do it, right? Well, you got to be careful. One, this is a paid ad. And two, the DAppRadar doesn't like necessarily verify the website. So it's not guaranteed that it's 100% safe. So please keep in mind with that. If you're looking at like OpenSea, Uniswap, MetaMask Swap, 1-inch network, if you look at the volumes, you know that it's going to be safer. But if you're going to go through a smaller option, for example, Foundation Marketplace with only 100K, there is going to be more risk on a smaller platform because you're just not really sure what's going to happen. So please keep in mind when you're doing that, and any of these websites that you click into and say, oh yeah, I want to go to OpenSea, please do research on OpenSea, for example, to understand the platform you're connecting your wallet to or you're putting your money on. So don't just 100% trust these third-party sites. Moving forward, we got a BNB chain. So this is just for the Binance Smart Chain. So if you really just like this type of ecosystem, then you could just come to the main website for that. So for the DAppRadar, that was more for an overview of multiple chains. While this one is just focused solely on this. So you can go, explore DApps, learn more. And then these are the top performing GameFi currently. And, I want to learn more about this one. Okay. Click on it. You can write a review and it'll give you, play to earn. Mining Tycoon is the blockchain game with virtual mining, et cetera, et cetera. You have a description. They have a Twitter account and you can do additional research if you feel like, this is something that interests me for. Now let's talk about one of the most common things that people like to do with the SafePal extension, and that's going to be the swaps. So we're going to have 1-inch. I'm going to launch it, and you're going to connect wallet. I'm going to read and accept the terms, so you can click onto this. You choose what network you plan on trading first, and then you pick a wallet. So again, if you don't see SafePal, just click on MetaMask, and then you can press connect. So just a reminder, only connect your wallet with the sites that you trust. Connect, and I'm going to open my SafePal wallet. Now that our wallet is open, I want to address a few features that we offer. Over here is our buy crypto. If you'd like to buy crypto, it'll be sent directly to your address. And this is the third party that's going to complete the transaction. And these are the three providers we currently offer. And each coin that you're trying to purchase, it's going to automatically tell you which provider is going to give you the best rate. And it's automatically adjusting in real time. Let's go back. And we also have our own internal swap. So if you don't want to complete a swap the way I'm showing you now, you can do it within SafePal extension. Just a reminder though, there is a minimum amount to use the SafePal extension, and it'll tell you we also have different providers as well. So you can click on that and you can say, for this pairing, it's not offered. It's offered on the Mexi exchange. So this is an option as well. And then you can click here and it'll show which DApps this wallet is currently connected to. You can click on edit. And I don't want to be connected to this one anymore. I can exit. I don't want to be connected to this one anymore. Okay, exit. But the good part is I might have just removed those DApps. If I didn't, I could have been using those simultaneously. So I'm on 1-inch. I'm on the DAppRadar. As you can see, my wallet is no longer connected. All right, click on here. Press connect. Now it's connected again. That quick. And you click on here. See? And I can use both these apps instantly. So if I'm making a transaction on 1-inch, I could still use my DAppRadar, no problem. So that being said, now let's move on to another swap. So 1 inch is primarily for Ethereum. And then we got PancakeSwap. Its primary is Binance Smart Chain. Connect your wallet. Oh, look. There is a SafePal logo, so you click on it. So if there is none, you can click on the MetaMask. If there is a SafePal logo, then you click the SafePal logo. Click on it, connect. And again, look at the DApps. If you're not using the apps, I actually recommend not keeping it connected for fun. And you should always exit out of it before you finish your sessions for the day. So before you exit out of your wallet, just come here and just exit. That is the best option. Done. Okay. Beautiful. It's the same concept. You click when you go in here, you type in the amount you want. And then, well, oh, it says inefficient funds. But you would type it in, you click swap, and there you go. And then normally in a few minutes, it'll be done. And that being said, moving forward, what is this, you may say? Ethereum Blockchain Explorer. So if you use these swaps, 1 inch, Pancake, or use the SafePal extension swap, they're going to leave a transaction ID, TRX ID. This ID can be plugged in into different explorers. And this tracks a transaction if it's completed or failed or just pending. And this is what this website is great for. This is specifically for Ethereum. So let's say you did a swap on 1 inch and it's a little slow. You haven't got your money. Well, you can insert your ID into here and it'll tell you what's the status of it. So we can even just look at other people's transactions as well. So you clicked here. Oh, this is a success. This was done an hour and a half ago. Value was $3. The transaction fee was $2. And this is the gas price. This also applies for Binance Smart Chain. So let's say you made a transaction on PancakeSwap. Same concept. You can then insert the transaction ID into Explorer if you wanted to track it. And you got another one. This is the Tron Blockchain Explorer, and this will track all your Tron transactions. Again, I prefer not to connect it, so this is not my first choice of checking transactions, to be honest. But again, to each his own. If you're happy with it, then there's no problem. Generally, when you connect your wallet for stuff like this, all they're doing is they're just reading the information on the wallet of just seeing how much Tron you have and what transactions you made specifically on the Tron network. So as long as you make sure that you're on the official Tron scan, you know, you're on the official Binance scan, etc. If you're not using a fake site, these are relatively safe. Again, it's not my first choice and you're better off just not connecting your wallet and just inserting your information manually. Or again, if you look at my wallet here, it literally says testing and it's connected to my iPhone and it's a testing wallet. So that means if I lose this $1.72 of Ethereum that I have, it's not the end of the world. And with how expensive gas fee is, unfortunately, I probably can't even take out this $1.72 anyways. Gas fee is charged by the blockchain and not particularly SafePal. So just keep that in mind, saying, oh, you have a dollar in your wallet, why don't you move it out? It's just not worth it. So we talked about DAppRadar and how to explore different DApps. We talked about explorers, how to check transactions. We talked about swapping and buying crypto. So now let's talk about NFTs. I'm personally not into NFT GameFi. So that's why I didn't really discuss it too much. But again, you can use the resources I provided previously to explore that avenue if that's something you guys are interested in. So there's two main NFT platforms that I prefer to use, and that's OpenSea and Magic Eden. Magic Eden is based on the Solana marketplace. That's what it's known for. So if you want Solana NFTs, I recommend doing Magic Eden. If you like to trade on for Ethereum NFTs, then I recommend OpenSea. And as you can see, both websites are going to have a trending page and the top page is going to say which ones are the most popular right now. Any project you want to click on, We'll say how many items, when it was created, the fees related to this. And for OpenSea, you need to look for blue checks. That means it was verified by the platform, and it'll tell you what social medias you can do. So again, even if you see it on OpenSea, it doesn't mean that there's no risk. You know, everything that you do, you must accept that you may lose your money. So please do your own research and do additional research on top of that. So don't, oh, I see on OpenSea, this looks cool, let me buy it. That is not a great strategy. And the same features is offered here. So the same concept, you can connect your wallet, and you need to connect your wallet to be able to purchase the NFTs. So it's the same thing, you just click on it. Instant. All right, click on it. Done. Now I'm connected to both these platforms. So if I want to make any transactions on them, I can just add funds, press swap, and there you go. Keep in mind, though, when you're trading NFTs, if you never use the platforms before, they're generally going to charge you additional fees on the normal transactions when you're buying and selling. So keep in mind, there is additional fees when you first use the platform. And once you complete and buy the NFT, it will be shown in your wallet. You just click on the NFT tab, and here you go. This is all spam. This is just from an NFT project that I bought previously, and they just gave me spam after purchasing it. So just keep in mind, when you're doing this, you don't have to worry about it. You can delete it if you like at a later point. Here. Click on manage NFTs. I don't want to show this one. Okay, now it's gone. Now that NFT is gone. And then at the top here is the extensions. Over here is the blockchains. You click on it, and there you go. You can display all your NFTs, and you're fine. The last thing I'm going to discuss about, so once you make your purchases, or you go, hey, I want to do additional research, there is some tools that people may find useful. NFT Go and NFT Rarity Sniper. So Rarity Sniper is a website that people like to use to track trades. So if you're not sure which NFT to buy, this website ranks your NFT. It's not 100% accurate, again, and I wouldn't be taking financial advice on it, but it may help if you're like on the fence of an NFT that you're looking to buy. You can use this website and go, oh, these are rank 76, 78. Oh, that's pretty cool. Out of 10,000, it's rank 70, right? That may be of interest for you. And for NFT Go, again, it's kind of like the DAppRadar. You can create a portfolio and you could check different analytics on different NFTs. It'll tell you the market overview and like specific projects, how much volume and how many holders and traders currently in the market for that specific project that you may look for. Again, these are just additional third-party tools, and I wouldn't rely on it 100% to make, you know, big purchases or when you're investing money into things. But these are just extra things you can use to get as much information as possible. So this completes our Web3 tour for today. My name is Michael, and thank you for joining us on the journey using the SafePal extension wallet and exploring different DApps together. If you have any questions or concerns, you can type in the YouTube comments below. Or if you want official help from an expert, you can go to the SafePal sitemap, contact customer support, and you submit a request. So these customer service agents will spend the time with you to solve any issues. So if you need additional help and a detailed response, this is the best way to do it. It says, how can I help? And you don't see your category here, just click on give us feedback. And the most important thing is having a detailed description add any images you may want to show, more information, better for the agents to obtain the information and then give you the best response possible. So that's it for today.